is I take these images, these exact images, literally, the Chandra images, and I use these mathematical techniques to quantify the morphology, like the shape of all of these different features, and then compare the different features between the reference to understand what happened in the explosion and how they interact with the stuff around them.
But like the stars in the Hoover Dome, right? Like it's not homogeneous. It's got like heterogeneous little pockets and crap in it. So
yeah, I mean, but basically the star is like an onion, where it has like lighter stuff on the outside, the pink on the outside, and then go farther in, you're gonna have the helium. And then a little farther in, then you'll have the carbon and the oxygen.
It's like when it explodes, it's still hydrogen outside.
Yeah, so usually you would expect sort of a shape where you have like, you know, the heavier elements toward the center and the lighter elements
around
the outside.
What are the different colors?
So the different colors, and this actually just correspond to the energies of the photons. So I think that it's, I don't remember exactly.
Oh, it's all x-rays, so it's just like...
Yeah, it's all different energy x-rays. It's just to show you that the lighter energy x-rays are here. The slightly heavier are the green, so it's the jets, and then the highest energy are the blue guys from the edge, which are, this is actually from the particle acceleration that occurs at the shockwave when a supernova explosion occurs.
How it hits the interstellar medium?
Yeah, so the shockwave grows out, it's so fast, and it interacts with all the particles that are just floating around in space, and actually the particles just go back and forth along the shockwave, and they gain energy every time they go back and forth along the shockwave. And this creates basically all of the cosmic rays of the universe. Like all of the really high energy light in the universe comes from this process, which is happening at this part.
It doesn't seem like that. I mean, it doesn't seem like that's a really energetic process.
Yeah, it's actually, it actually is like where all the high energy stuff comes from.
So is it kind of like a laser sort of? Does it like multiply?
It just that each time, each time it goes across the shock, it gains some amount of energy, and it just keeps going so many times that it goes up.
Why does it reflect?
It's just a random, like, it's actually just a natural diffusion process where